bush, so sit back and enjoy the show. Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, there lived a brother and sister named Hansel and Gretel.
I'm Hansel, and I'm Gretel. We're Hansel and Gretel.
Yes, just as I said. They lived in a cottage in the woods with...
I'm Hansel. I'm Gretel. We're Hansel and Gretel.
Enough. They lived in a cottage in the woods with their father, who loved them very much. And their stepmother, who had the same
husband, your children are driving me crazy.
I'm Hansel. I'm Gretel. Take them to the woods and leave them.
But darling, they'll get laundry.
Don't worry. The nice witch will come feed them gingerbread.
Oh, they like gingerbread. Come on, kids.
So the stereotypical, clueless father took Hansel and Gretel far, far away and left them. However, he made one mistake. Instead of leaving them in the woods...
Why did Daddy leave us in the woods? So it's slippery. Ow!
Finally, Gretel realized he was not coming back.
Daddy's not coming back. How will we find our way back to the house?
Look, it's over there. You can see it.
So they walked home and jumped on the couch and got stickers all over it. Their stepmother had heard the noise and came out to see.
Oh, they're back.
Their stepmother had a splitting headache when she called her husband.
Husband?
Yes, sir.
She told him where to take those noisy children.
Take those noisy children over the hill and deep into the woods and leave them.
But darling, they'll get hungry.
Don't worry, I'll let them open the door for comfy.
Oh, they like that.
So their father took them over the hill and through the twisted, scary trees, past the dens of hideous, smelly, unsupervised creatures. They watched them as they passed through a clearing. Their father patted them on the head and gave them some words of wisdom.
They love to sneeze for me, kids!
Their father headed home, wishing he was going to have the gingerbread for breakfast.
Gingerbread.
Hansel and Gretel stood around as the forest got darker and darker.
I'm Hansel. I'm Gretel.
Hansel and Gretel stood around as the forest got darker and darker. The crickets chirped. The owls hooted. The moon came out. The wolves howled. Hansel and Gretel began to realize the danger they were in. Oh my, it's morning. Must have fallen asleep. Looks like it was an uneventful night. Gretel shook Hansel awake.
Gretel, I think you're so late this morning. What's for breakfast?
Hansel and Gretel introduced themselves.
I'm Hansel. I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
And I'm a nice old lady. My house is over there.
I'm Hansel.
I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
The nice old lady was really a wicked witch who likes to eat children. She took them into her house. Gretel looked around. Hansel and Gretel. Hansel was getting hungry, so he asked again.
What's for breakfast?
The witch invited them to hop into a big pot of hot water, she said.
Why are there potatoes and carrots and celery floating in that?
So Hansel and Gretel, who never were the brightest candles ever taken, popped them into the pot.
What is it?
It's too terrible to tell you.
Tell us.
other noses until they found
a big pot of soup.
Soup?
Where?
I'm hungry.
Children's soup.
The dwarves tried to rescue the children. Unfortunately, they weren't very organized.
1, 2, 3.
They only made it worse. The dwarves yelled for the children to get out.
Get out! Get out!
That witch wants to cook you and eat you.
But the children had been in the hot water too long.
I'm melting.
Hansel and Gretel fainted in the hot water, and it was getting hotter. The dwarves tried to lift them out.
1, 2, 3, lift!
But the witch flapped her arms and yelled,
"Stop that right now!"
The leader of the elves was very brave.
"Let them go, you mean old witch!
You let them go, or I'll turn you on four panthers."
Their leader had an idea. She told Gretel.
"Gretel, call your fairy godmother." Morning,
Christmas.
from their suit in haste heat shrug. They introduce themselves to the dwarves.
I'm Hansel.
Hi, I'm Gretel.
We're Hansel and Gretel.
We're the 11 dwarves.
Hansel was sad to see them go.
Bye, sneaky twins. You are my favorites.
When their father came out the door, he was very happy to see them and very sorry he had left them out in the forest. He called to his wife,
"Honey, the kids are home."
Oh, no.
Parenting.